Hi everyone, it's Nikka. As protests continue throughout the US over the death of George Floyd, Tayo News wants to shine a light on how people from our community are working to fight racial injustice. First, by helping bring an end to racism within our own homes and our community through various ways such as education, sports, and even fashion. These headlines are coming your way starting now. Here's a topic that we're seeing many of our Tayo fam tackling these days. Talks about race and Black lives with our families.
I think it's really important to talk to family, to talk to parents. You know, our parents might be a little bit more difficult to convince because they've had a longer time to like let those beliefs sit and solidify.
As a first generation Filipino-American, it is my duty to have difficult conversations with my family members.
So how do we get those tough conversations started? One tool that's being shared on social media takes its cue from Letters for Black Lives, a set of crowdsourced resources aimed at creating a space for open and honest conversations on anti-blackness. We've come across a couple versions of these shareable art cards by Krizia Yanga and Trish Alvaro that have Tagalog translations to help guide us in our talks with our loved ones, particularly our elders. Let us know in the comments if you're having these conversations in your own family, and tell us how they're going. More members of our community are stepping up to the plate to take a swing at racism. And Now Batting, a popular baseball podcaster known as the Baseballogist, has collaborated with artist Leroy David for his powerful artwork. Among sports leagues, Major League Baseball was among the slowest to condemn the killing of George Floyd. Leroy and the Baseballogist hope this art, along with the hashtags community, could spark the conversations among those who follow America's pastime. It really does start at home, and educating yourself and your loved ones is one way you can support the Black Lives Matter movement. We'd love to know how you've been taking part in the movement and share with us some other ways we can too. In the wake of the Black Lives Matter protests, tensions reached a high. Stores across the country were looted, including many streetwear boutiques, leaving shop owners upset. Editorial director of High Snobiety, Gian De Leon, dove deep into the issue with his article, "Streetwear is about people, not clothes." Gian takes a look at the evolution of streetwear and how the culture, which was built on a spirit of rebellion, has now been commodified. If you're into streetwear fashion, this is definitely a read for you. Bamboo bike maker, Connecticut native Brian Benitez McClellan is committed to preserving nature and helping out essential workers in the Philippines during the COVID-19 pandemic. Ever since Metro Manila, where he now lives, was placed under enhanced community quarantine back in March, Brian has been planting one tree a day. That's already about 80 trees and counting. That's on top of the work he's already doing through his company, Bambike. His bikes are helping those fighting on the front lines get to work safely while maintaining social distance and reducing their carbon footprint. Thanks for watching another episode of Tayo News. 2020 has brought on a lot at us, but it's important to stand together and spread kindness more than ever during these times. Stay safe out there and stay informed with Tayo News. I'll see you next time.